It's actually crazy to think that Russell Westbrook and Cam Newton have somehow became my two favorite athletes, not only currently, but probably of all time in their respective sports. From being one of the most athletic players at their positions all time, to being memorable fashion icons, to being two of the most highly scrutinized guys during their careers from the media and fans. Russ and Cam both have similarities that I've noticed over the past couple years, and it's finally time I talk about it. Now, I will say this might be a little bit of a stretch when it comes to these guys and their comparison in their careers, but I'm just having fun linking the two sports I love the most. With that being said, I made a similar video on how Lamar Jackson is the Giannis Antetokounmpo of the NFL. That video will be on the card on the screen right now. You can go watch that after this one. But without further ado, let's get into this video. First off, let's talk about how both these guys are such athletic freaks. Let's start with Russell Westbrook. In my mind, Russ is the most athletic point guard of all time. Many will argue that a prime D Rose is more athletic, and it's close, but I'll go with Russ. Russ on a consistent basis is the fastest guy on the court and still jumps higher than most guys as well. Not only that, but he's also one of the strongest point guards we've ever seen. And he uses that strength to his advantage with his increased post-up game over the past couple years. In fact, many teams have to put bigger and even taller defenders on him to negate his athletic ability and strength that he uses to abuse point guards on a consistent basis. The most impressive part about Russ's athletic ability is the fact that he plays with the exact same energy night in and night out, 13 seasons in now. The guy is always playing at 100 miles per hour. There would never be another Russell Westbrook. Cam Newton, on the other hand, is also a one of one when it comes to his athleticism. When you think of mobile or running quarterbacks, you more than likely think of guys like Lamar Jackson and Michael Vick and their electrifying style of play with how quick they are, combined with their level of agility and elusivity that they bring to the table. The thing about those guys is, they're both under 6'3", and both of them are under 215 pounds. Cam Newton is about 6'5", and 250 pounds and still doing most of the things that those guys are doing. Obviously, he's not as slippery or as elusive as those guys, but no doubt he's just as feared by opposing defenses. Cam running the way he does makes no sense due to his size. He's literally bigger than some linebackers, but running faster than some running backs. Opposing teams don't want to have to deal with a guy with the combination of strength and speed. His size and strength also comes in handy when he's in the pocket as well. He has the crazy ability to shake off edge defenders that fly towards him and the ability to keep his legs moving even if there's a guy draped all over him. With that being said, Cam is the most athletic quarterback in NFL history, and he still has much athleticism left in the tank despite what many people might think. Next up, let's talk about how each of these guys' careers has panned out so far. Both guys came in as high draft picks and were looked to as guys that were going to come in and turn the franchise around. Both guys got off to great starts. The Thunder began to routinely make deep playoff runs, and the Panthers started to become a playoff caliber team, although it took a little bit longer. Now, I understand in football there's more things that have to go right in order for a team to have success over an extended period of time, so it is harder to sustain that success as an individual and as a team. Both guys became MVPs and quickly became one of the best players at their respective positions. Although their MVPs didn't come in the same type of scenario, they both showed how dominant they could be when given the opportunity. During Cam's MVP season, he coasted through the regular season and through the playoffs up until the Super Bowl. In that game, Cam underperformed and had his worst game of the season at the worst possible time. He threw 18 for 41, which is only 43%, the lowest percentage he had all season. Granted, he did go up against one of the best defenses of all time in the 2015 Broncos. And we all remember the strip sack in the fourth quarter caused by Von Miller, in which Cam Newton didn't dive for the loose ball when he had the clear opportunity to. At the time, the Panthers were only down 6 with 4 minutes to go in the game. He had a chance to win a championship, but he didn't step up to the occasion against one of the greatest defenses of all time. On Russ's end of a championship shortcoming, in 2012, he, Kevin Durant, and James Harden reached the finals as a very young squad. And of course, they went up against Miami's big three of LeBron James, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Bosh. The Thunder lost that series in 5, as they're expected to lose by the majority anyways. From the outside looking in, people say that that series wasn't close, but indeed, the Thunder actually had a fourth quarter lead in 3 of those 5 games. Maybe a bit more experience would have been the difference for Russ and OKC winning a championship back then. Speaking of leads, in 2016, Russ and the Thunder blew a 3-1 lead to the Warriors, and in that series, Russ had one of the worst 3-game stretches you'll ever see from a superstar player. In games 5, 6, and 7, he shot 36% from the field and averaged about 5 turnovers per game, including shooting 7 for 21 in a game 7. And we also remember in game 6 when Russ got stripped by Andre Iguodala, which led to the Klay Thompson 3 to give the Warriors a late lead. This of course led to the Thunder losing the game and the series eventually. Many people, including myself, do believe the Thunder would have beaten the Cavs in 2016, but hey, the world will never know. I say all that to say that Cam and Russ both came very close to winning championships, but came up short due to a couple reasons. One, both of them running into historically great teams, underperforming in big time moments, and having bad luck on their side. Now, both of these guys are sort of frowned upon, and were both labeled as quote unquote washed or quote unquote a shell of himself just in the past year alone. Newton dealt with injuries that kept him out for over a year, got traded to the Patriots, but he didn't have the offensive weapons, and that was ironically the reason why he was in New England in the first place. Tom Brady had left the Patriots because he himself didn't have enough weapons, along with him and Bill Belichick not seeing eye to eye, of course. Nonetheless, the Patriots still managed to go a respectable 7-9, considering they did that without any explosive offensive weapons on the outside for Cam, as well as him missing a couple games. This upcoming season, Cam Newton actually has weapons to throw the ball to, and he's healthy, so we'll see if Cam is actually washed or not. With Russ, he's already proven that he isn't washed. After he got traded from his longtime franchise in OKC, he went on to Houston, but things didn't work out there with him and James Harden. He got injured right before the playoffs, came back, lost in round 2, and eventually got traded to the Wizards. After a slow start in DC, guess what? He was labeled washed as well. But as all y'all have seen, as the season went along, it was evident that he indeed wasn't washed and just had a bad start to the year, partly due to injury and partly due to the team around him not being talented. Sounds kind of familiar to Cam's situation, right? Well, now there will be no shortage of talent surrounding Russ in LA now. Now let's talk about how both of these guys have been two of the most scrutinized athletes of this generation. Oh boy, where do I even begin? I guess we can start talking about how the media paints these guys in a false light, which allows fans to come up with narratives, stories, and perspectives that simply aren't fair to Russ and Cam. Starting off with Russ, he gets a bad reputation of being a tough guy to deal with on and off the court. Maybe it's the way in which he approaches the game, and that turns a lot of people off about him. Correction, no doubt the way Russell Westbrook approaches the game turns off a lot of people. We all know that Russ plays with an intensity that we've rarely ever seen before, from his angry faces to him mean mugging to him trash talking on the court to his demonstrative attitude. In the midst of all that, we know he isn't the most efficient player, as he tends to fall in love with taking jumpers, whether he's making them or not. Therefore, Russ has been blamed extensively when it came to his teammates underperforming, his team underperforming, and his coaches not being good enough. And the list goes on and on. He was the one to blame when the KD and Russ era in OKC failed. He was the one to blame when KD left for Golden State. He was the one to blame for all the first round exits in OKC after KD left. On the flip side, Cam has had his own tainted perception like Russ. Cam is also a very emotional and passionate guy as well. He loves to celebrate, he loves to trash talk, etc, etc, and people look at that and say he's cocky. Cam also isn't the greatest when it comes to talking to the media. As we've seen before, he goes off on reporters and even walks off on them, similar to what we've seen from Russ in the past. Cam has gotten a bad teammate that is selfish and is all about himself label as well. And to go along with that, Cam himself isn't the most efficient player. As we know, his completion percentage is rarely over 60%, and in the NFL, that's not seen as a good thing, just like how Russ routinely shoots under 44%, which also isn't seen as a good thing. Former teammates of both of these guys have spoken glowingly about them, respectively, but the media, for some reason, wants to paint these guys as bad guys, which then leads to many fans either loving or hating, with seemingly nothing in between. To wrap this thing up, these two guys are two of the most athletic athletes to ever play any sport as far as I'm concerned. It's about time we appreciate for what they've done so far in their careers. Of course, not to the fullest extent yet because their careers aren't over and they still got a lot left in the tank. But let's not act like these two guys aren't legends, icons, great players that are generational. But with that being said, let me know what you think about this Russell Westbrook Cam Newton comparison. I think that's the closest comparison you can get to either guy. Y'all let me know what y'all think. Should I do more of these NFL NBA superstar comparisons? If so, who do you want me to talk about next? But with that being said, this is Jimmy from Just the Facts, and I'm signing out. Peace.